Happy Easter, everyone. As a church, we will have the opportunity to participate in communion during the Good Friday service online. For some of you, the idea of leading communion in your home may seem a little bit intimidating, so the family ministry team is here to help. Communion is an important part of worshiping God as we remember Jesus' sacrifice. Jesus specifically instructed that we partake communion in remembrance of Him. When talking with your kids, point out that when we remember special days, we replay the day in our mind. This is what Jesus wants us to do. We are to think about communion with Jesus as if He were there with us. And of course, it's important to take time to reflect and pray as we partake in communion. Teaching young people about communion and its importance will help them grow into committed disciples of Jesus Christ. Let's look at the book of Luke chapter 22. When the hour came, Jesus and his apostles reclined at the table, and he said to them, "I have eagerly desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer, for I tell you, I will not eat it again until it finds fulfillment in the kingdom of God." So after taking the cup, he gave thanks and said, "Take this, divide it among you. For I tell you, I will not drink again from the fruit of the vine until the kingdom of God comes." And he took the bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to them, saying, "This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And the same way, after the supper, he took the cup, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in which is my blood, which is poured out for you."
Now, when you are selecting your elements, there are a few different options that you may have in your house. You may have some regular sandwich bread, which works great. You could also have some fancy baked bread, which is also awesome. But I think the younger your kids are, the simplest option would be something like these saltine crackers. Now, as mom and dad, and in this moment, you get to minister to your kids. What a privilege. What you're going to do at this moment is you're going to remind them that this bread or this cracker is representative of the body of Christ, which was broken for our healing and for our redemption. So in the moment, once each of your kids has a cracker or a piece of bread, what you can say is, "This is my body that was broken for you." So your child will break the bread and take it.
Okay, now when it comes to the cup of Christ, we want it to make as simple as possible, just like the bread was. Now, if you have juice, that's great, because we believe that the juice fully represents the blood and the cup of Christ. Like we did, we went to Walgreens and we got some Welch's juice, so that'll work just fine. And after the meal, Jesus took the cup, saying to his disciples, "This cup, it's the new covenant in my blood, shed for the forgiveness of your sins. And every time you drink from it, do it in remembrance of me." So it's simple, parents. Just pour your family a cup of juice and drink it together so we can partake of the cup of Christ together.
Jesus says, "As often as you do this, do it in remembrance of me." We're remembering the sacrifice of Jesus. Communion is as much spiritual mystery as physical reality. Think about it with me. When we take communion together, we are joining together with 2,000 years of Jesus' church. The simple act of communion is a physical act of faith where we identify with the immeasurable sacrifice of the cross. Jesus, he's fully man, but fully God. Only a man could die for the sins of another man, but only a God could swallow up the wrath of God. Take a moment for a second and consider how special it is to lead your family in partaking communion together. I want to leave you guys with a simple blessing. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. God bless you.